huge update on the ongoing situation in Kashmir. It would seem as though India has now conducted bombings inside of Pakistan. India was targeting the group Jaish Mohammed, which is the group responsible apparently for the bombing in Kashmir, which killed about 37 Indian troops last week. India has accused Pakistan of supporting this terror group and considering them to be a an ally of the state, which Pakistan, of course, denies. And of course, they added the ridiculous caveat that the Pakistani government, oh, we never fund any terrorist groups. That's crazy. Well, we know that's not true. All governments fund terrorists. It's just a matter of whether this group was or was not. But those are all minor details now, because history was made last night, or rather this morning, in Indian time, because the Indian Air Force and no Indian troops had ever crossed the line of control in Kashmir since the war in 1971. Both Pakistan and India had been able to stay behind their lines and not cross that. Now, India has made the first strike now and bombed inside of Pakistan. This is the first time that a nuclear state has conducted any sort of military operation uninvited in another nuclear state. This is perhaps the most dangerous situation of my lifetime, for that very reason. If Pakistan responds in kind, we could get into a tit-for-tat that would continue to escalate until the two countries are in a state of thermonuclear war. Now, from what I understand, the nuclear arsenals of India and Pakistan are not exactly, say, you know, the U.S. and Russia. Their bombs could not necessarily blow up the entire surface of the Earth, you know, three times over. But what they would end up doing is destroying each of each other's countries, and then the smoke clouds, from what I understand, would cloud out in the atmosphere and sit there for years, and we would get a little ice age. The smoke from the bombs would be so thick as to block out the sun, and then essentially deprive the planet of solar energy. And I don't just mean solar electricity, I mean all of the solar energy absorbed by plants that we then eat. We would no longer be able to grow enough food to sustain the current global population, and people would starve to death everywhere unless we found some kind of alternative. But I don't think we're there yet. I think all sort of food, artificial type food, is still derived from plants in some way. So we're not looking at a nuclear holocaust potentially here, at least not if you live outside of Pakistan or India. But for the rest of the world, we're certainly looking at a nuclear winter if this escalates any further. Now, it's very unfortunate that the Indians decided to escalate to this point, and I know they see this as a defensive action because they consider Jaish Mohammed to be working for Pakistan, and they very well might be. However, that doesn't make nuclear war somehow less problematic for the planet. After the bombings went off, I've been following the reports of the planes flying into Kashmir. There are very large transport ship or planes landing there that could be bringing anything: artillery, tanks, troops. There were certain, you know, C-130s and things, you know, real large cargo planes flying in. So India certainly expects a ground war, it would seem, with Pakistan. And a conventional ground war is just about one step removed from thermonuclear war in terms of intensity. There is no greater escalation after a ground war except for nuclear war. The Pakistanis, for their part, seem to be trying to downplay the whole situation. They posted pictures of the craters left by the Indian bombs today, and they said, oh yeah, they didn't even hit anything. There was nothing here. And they just dropped their bombs because they were trying to unload weight so they could escape the wrath of Pakistani fighter planes that we had scrambled. Well, the way the Indians tell the story, that's not quite true. The Indians say that they bombed three terrorist camps and killed about 300 men. And additionally, they made it very far into Pakistan, much further than you would expect if they were Pakistani fighters were hot on their tail as soon as they crossed into Pakistani airspace. Apparently, the Pakis were not too quick to respond to the Indian Air Force, and they were caught kind of flat-footed. Nevertheless, after this, I think a lot of people in Pakistan will be quite embarrassed, and you're probably going to have a lot of saber-rattling in the media in Pakistan, as we've already seen in India. The Indian media is just cheerleading this 100% from what I've seen, at least the mainstream media. And I don't think that the Pakistanis will want to take this sitting down, even if the military, thankfully, seems to have a bit of a cooler head about all of this and understands the risks. The question then becomes, can the military resist the popular urge for war? I don't know. And would the Indians even be interested in de-escalating at this point? Because they're certainly not talking that way. The Indian government still sounds quite aggressive, which is rather frightening. So that's all we know for now. Stay tuned to this channel. I'll keep providing updates as they come out about India and Pakistan. I think this just elevated to be the most important story in the world as of right now, so it's my top focus. So if you made it this far, please do like this video and hit the subscribe button. Very much appreciated, and I'll see you folks tomorrow.